Hey folks, hope everybody's having a great weekend, great week, great life. Come on, I'm not doing any more free commercials for JB Weld. They can go blow. But today, we are going to look at Ernie Ball, Music Man Stingray. And it's a beauty. Beautiful maple neck. Fantastic. Just not wonderful. This should be, I always say that and then I gooch myself. We're going to put a set of flat wounds on this guy. And a little bit of setup and some truss rod adjustment. The neck's got a bit of a back bow to it right now, just a tiny bit. So, I don't know, I'll stick the camera on the bench and we'll go at it. Stand by. So, first step is we're going to take off the old strings. And depending on how stable your bass guitar is, and also depending on how long you leave the strings off it, it can be pretty traumatic, and truss rod adjustments may be required. So just remember that, you know, if you want to play it safe and you're changing your bass guitar strings, or even your guitar strings as far as that goes, change them all one at a time, unless you want to do some cleanup on your guitar. It's pretty difficult to do with all the strings on it. And that's all I'll say about that. We all learn lessons the hard way. Hey, strings are off it. It's a good time to do a little cleanup. Someone freaked out on me because I was using lighter fluid to clean the guitar. Oh geez, never use that. Never use that, the person said. I've been using it for many, many years. And I have never had a bad result. Even if the wood is unfinished, it will remove a lot of gunk and it evaporates immediately. Don't use it on your fretboard, it'll dry it out. Yeah, well, so will the frickin' normal air. If it's rosewood. Rosewood is naturally oily. That's why if you're gonna use a few drops of linseed oil, you only need to do that once a year. There. Oh, maybe a little bit of... See, isn't that nice? A little bit of cleanup around the bridge. Just because the strings are off of it. You guys can't see me doing that. I could be rubbing one out over here and you'd never know. Okay. We're all cleaned up. Really... guitar is pretty clean to begin with. Let's get these beautiful strings on the guitar. So, a flat wound string. Let's make sure I put the right string in the right post. Flat wound string offers more tension on the neck than a round wound string. That's because there is more surface area. So what you're doing is stretching something that's a little more solid than a string that's round wound. Oh, let's hold on. I'm going to show you this little trick one more time. If you want to get the right amount of wraps on the post without... you know, well, there's one trick. If the old strings had the right amount of wrap, then compare them and snip it off. But if it didn't, then it's going in this post. We go to the next one. We go to the next one. And we pretend that there's a fourth one there. And that's it. That's where you snip it. I'm going to add just a little bit of grease there. And off it goes. Goes into the hole. And down we go. And we start to wrap. That's fucking great. Loving it. Okay. Strings are all on it. Nicely tuned up to pitch. Yeah. So, let's just unplug there. Let's just check the curve of the neck, the relief of the neck, the space that the strings need to vibrate in. I hope things are in the movie there. And my feeler gauge tells me that that's about right. I'm a little on the shy side. I'm going to just loosen the truss rod a hair. And it's really convenient on these guitars with that wonderful spoke nut that's in there. Let's just see. Well, she's pretty tight, so let's go about an eighth of a turn. And see if we got any instantaneous results with that. And I like that. That's the 0.012 neck relief. Now we'll check the string height. And oh, things are falling. Check the string height. At the 17th fret, and I want to see 5/64ths. And the E string looks great. The A string needs to come up a smidge. And when you're doing these adjustments here, the bridge saddle should always be parallel to the body of the guitar. They shouldn't be like cockeyed. They're all going to be different heights, but they shouldn't be all slanted. A string looks great. D string, same thing. Needs to come up just a hair. Thinking the E string needs to come up a hair as well, just a smidge, just a bit. Yeah, I'm gonna tweak the A string again a little bit too. Again, just take a minute while I'm doing this to thank everybody for all the support, and big shout out to all my new and old subscribers. Thank you so much. Okay, almost got happiness there. We'll tune it back up to pitch and measure this all again. Sometimes difficult to see. That's why I have this big magnifier. Yeah,
D string needs to come up a little bit. And as I'm measuring, I don't know if it's in the movie or not. Could be a bad camera. I'm actually pushing the string above out of the way so I can see my measurement. I'm happy with that. Let's tune it back up to pitch and go from there. Take a second to I'm loving it. One more little check here. Yeah, beautiful. Okay, intonation time. Somebody asked me to sort of explain a little bit about the Peterson and how it works. Okay. You can go to their website and there's, you know, the full-on manual if you want to read that. But inside, the way it, excuse me, the way it actually produces a reference is with a quartz crystal. This tuner never has to be calibrated, okay? And if you don't believe me, you can go to the Peterson website and they'll tell you the same thing. So, right now, it's sort of just spinning away in the dirt. And just go through the display. We're tuning in the key of C, A440. This one that's changing here now, it's trying to find a note. It's probably picking up what I'm saying. That one, I forget what it does. Right now, it's an automatic, and the setup mode is automatic. We can change the modes, change the key, go up and down, different amounts and cents. If you want to do that, you can choose an individual note. You can change the display's octave for tuning lower notes. You can actually plug the amp, your effects loop through it if you want. Right now I'm just using the internal microphone. But anyway, that's sort of the Peterson. It's dead ass simple. When we tune a note, you'll see the display says G. And also you'll see the strobe spinning, which tells me that it's a tiny bit sharp. And that's that. So let's just continue. Hold on. Okay, so the Peterson is telling me that the D string is a little bit sharp. And we're always going to check this in the playing position as well. But it's easier to get it laying down, and then you pick it up, and 9 times out of 10, it doesn't affect anything. So, I've been bitched about that before too. I'm getting used to being bitched at. So, the string's a little sharp, which means it's short, which means we got to pull the bridge saddle back a hair. Retune to pitch. Again, tiny bit more, and then I'll check it in the playing position. Next.
I think I left the camera recording nothing. Once again, turn off the Peterson here. It's lack of use. Spin it a bunch of times. Okay, so that's that. Pretty straight ahead. Just looking here. Breaking my own rule. One of the bridge saddles was leaning over a little bit. But we'll let it sit and settle in. And then we'll check it all again. Oh, hey, my phone's going off. Somebody likes me. Yay! All right, folks. Thanks for stopping in. Thanks for the support. Oops, we got the Ernie Ballsack Music Man Stingray. Cheers.